is, oh no, I'm going to be this, and I'm going to force you all to come with me, whether you like it or not, this is what's happening. And you might not like it, and it's going to put you all on tenterhooks for a bit, and it's going to, you know, you're all going to be, and there's this weird kind of skepticism. But actually, I felt real warmth for Jodie, which I think, honestly, she's such a brilliant actress, and she's such a nice person. And I think that really, when you're playing a doctor, you know, if I do say so myself, you sort of have to be intrinsically, you know, a good person in many ways, because you know, because he is, and she is, and yeah, I think I'm really excited. Yeah, and also she's from a part of England, which is, she's from the north of England, and there's a sort of earthiness to her, and she's funny. I think she's going to be really, really good. I think it's going to be a good time to talk to you.
Building on that, did you have a chance to talk to Jodie and give her a pep talk or
something? Yeah. I have actually. I was like, good luck, mate. You have no idea. Because I don't know what I'm going to do. You have no idea. Because nothing, what can it, you know, what, here I am, 4 years later or whatever it is, or 2 or 3 years, you know, and you know, we talk about this, me and Dave and people, we're like, it's such a mad journey. And here we are all still talking about Doctor Who. There's a Doctor Who ball tonight, for God's sake. What the hell goes on there?
You'll have to show up and find him.
It comes as a Silurian or something, I think. Yeah, I actually had a bit of a costume on last night, but it was really hot. It was a cool hat, and I had a cool, like, I've
had a cool vest.
Yeah, it was a vest. Sorry, anyway.
Next
question.
Hi. First, my best friend Emily Smith, she couldn't be here, so I promised that I would tell you that she says hi.
Emily Smith. I like your last name. into the first one, but I'm more into the second one. We're all having a marvellous time without you. Come on, I'm going to call it what it is. I'm not going to lie. We wish you were here, but you're not. But we're going to have a good time anyway. I doodle the same thing, versions of the same thing, over and over and over again, and it's, I don't know, it probably, you know, has something to do with the deep psychological problems that are in there. It's just little phases. What can happen if you want? But the deal is, you've got to give one to someone else. A stranger. Nervous energy, so I sort of have to do several things at the same time. It's like I'm always singing a song in my head. I don't know, it's strange. Anyway, next question.
It's all the pheromones from the room, right?
Exactly.
Next question.
Hello, my name is Calden.
Hey.
You're my favorite doctor.
Oh, thanks, man.
I was wondering from when you first figured out that you were going to be the doctor, what was your reaction?
Oh gosh. Nothing could prepare you for that, to be honest with you. It's, I was sort of on a street, and my agent rang me up and told me that I was going to go and have this meal with Stephen Moffat and a couple of the head people at the BBC, and that at the meal, you know, and then I would be sort of formally offered it, as it were. And it's quite strange, really, because it's such a huge thing in Britain. It's so ingrained in the sort of in the cultural identity of the country, really. So it's a mixture of isolation and anxiety, and then you're slightly intimidated by the prospect of this great big job that you've got to do because the doctor's such a wonderful part. But with me, I couldn't tell anyone for like 4 or 5 months. So it was quite strange, and I knew for such a long time, and people would go, see an actor's that actor talk, so what are you doing next? And they've got like, you know, knowing that they're doing like 5 jobs or something, and I'd be like, oh, nothing. And a lot of my friends were like, you lied to me for ages. I'm like, yeah. And they're like, why didn't you let me place a bet? And then I was doing like press for another job, and at press you like have round tables where, you know, 10 or so journalists will be sat there, and they ask questions, and there was this other actor that I was working with, and I was sat with him, and the whole time they were like, are you the new Doctor Who? And I was like, because no one suspected me, because no one knew who I was.
And I was going to ask you if you had heard, you know, around town when somebody was like, oh, so I've got this scoop, so-and-so is going to be the new Doctor, and you're like, oh, wow.
There was loads of that type of thing. So I felt very smug.